What's going? Yeah, it says it has 2 hours and 47 minutes.
But it really has like a...
Well, because the battery, you know what I mean? But our video was actually an hour and 40 minutes long.
Yeah, last week.
It's on YouTube right now. Well, they turned that shop over there into an Ohio State store, didn't they, or something?
Man, my YouTube, my computer, man, it slows my computer down.
Now you got to have a supercomputer just to browse the internet.
It slows my computer down.
I can't get on the internet with my old computers no more. It's so fucking slow. Mm-hmm. Hey, even on my brand new computer, I got a i5 chip in it. It's like one of the best chips out there.
Right.
Should be slow, man. They say the whole internet's being slowed down.
It's frustrating.
Every time I use dad's old ass laptop, it's like pages not responding.
They blame it on a bunch of, they say that everyone watching Netflix on the internet now is slowing the internet down. Plus a lot of...
They can start storage Netflix different.
They
Netflix
already did.
Start charging different.
Yeah, they
already
did.
They already did that.
The price of Netflix went up, but people who already got grandfathered in.
That's dumb though, they should've fucking... People should watch TV on their TV.
Fuck that.
Time to end, people shouldn't be watching TV, period.
Right, that's what I'm saying. The internet should be used for fucking internet shit, not TV.
That's the script. I got the script. That's
the
script. And it's
Mark 13
to 32.
Yeah,
it was
older than
us.
In that hour.
Do a pop, shove it.
What are you doing?
Do a kickflip.
You better be careful. You're gonna get hurt. That's what's
gonna
happen.
You're about to get a fucking face busted open.
Hey, see your pretty teeth get knocked out. She playing it safe, shit. You ain't gonna see me on no skateboard.
She about got broke trying to dodge them people.
Go ahead, read that.
It's Mark 13, 32. But that day and that hour knoweth no man. No, not the angels which are in heaven, neither the Son, but the Father. Take ye heed, watch and pray. For ye know not when the time is. For the Son of Man is as a man taking a far journey, who left his house and gave authority over to his servants and to every man his work. You know what I'm saying?
Well, yeah, that's right, because the Lord, he's gone on a long journey right now. You know what I'm saying? He ain't even home. He ain't at the house. So what do you think the Lord's going to do? He left, came back. It's like the, you know, like that movie Risky Business. Tom Cruise's parents went away. They threw a big ass party. Hey, the parents came home, shit's all fucked up. You gonna tell me he's not gonna be mad? They didn't trash the house, trash the whole planet.
What's the other one, Ferris Bueller?
Yeah, Ferris Bueller, that's it. Oh, yeah.
Parents leave and they just lose their mind. Yeah.
Lose their goddamn mind, man. Go ahead.
And commanded the porter to watch. Watch ye therefore. For ye know not when the master of the house cometh, at evening or at midnight, or at the cock crowing, or in the morning, these coming suddenly, he shall find you sleeping. And what I say unto you, I say unto all, watch.
That's right.
Yeah, so you gotta be watching, you gotta stay up on your P's and your Q's. You can't be bullshitting, man.
Like you said, you catch them with your pants down.
Like, they not a day goes by when I'm not reading the news, you know, looking at what's going on in the world. If I see something that happens in the news that I think is a big time story, I'll let everybody know about it. But it ain't here for bear. You can't say I didn't warn you. You know what I'm saying? They think I'm crazy. Like, this guy's a conspiracy theorist. I'm a conspiracy theorist because I watch the news.
High as fuck.
Get on my camera. She's on that fucking water.
That's nothing. She's not even on beat or not. She just rocking.
That's that crackhead rock.
Yeah.
Well, you see them, they be on the corner just doing their rock. These people gone out here, man.
The Lord said you're going to come back like a thief in the night. And a thief don't come in your door and knock and say, I'm about to come and steal your shit at 5 o'clock.
Holla.
None of these people are aware. So it's going to come on them unawares. And, like you said, with their pants down.
That's right.
So they keep, gonna keep watching.
Ain't nothing like catching the motherfuckers with their pants down.
Literally, pants down. Yeah. That's like, literally, and metaphorically.
Second Peter 3:9. The Lord is not slack concerning his promise, as some men count slackness, but is long-suffering to us, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in the which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat.
That's going to talk about that nuclear destruction. That great fire that's going to be, when Russia starts shooting those missiles, that goddamn country is going to get devoured by those flames. It's going to be a beautiful day. I can't wait to see this shit get destroyed.
Here we are broadcasting the news, the good news, and look.
That's because there's no light in them. I mean, because we're surrounded by evil demons, man. He's just looking into people's eyes and you just see nothing.
Right. Blank. It's all blank.
It's blank. It's not even a person in there nowhere. The whole spirit is dead. Yep. It's like Ezekiel talking about that valley of dry bones. Look, there you go, right there.
Walking dead.
Walking dead, man. Motherfuckers is gone. They dead. They're spiritually dead.
That's the new sitcom, The Destruction of the Walking Dead. That's the missiles dropping.
Reality show.
Right, a reality show, right?
That'd be the best reality show ever.
Motherfucker with a distance camera from a distance catching, getting hit with tactical small nukes.
That gets real good ratings.
Right. See, motherfuckers' pulp body just.
I hate watching gooks walk by.
Yeah, they hate you walking by too. Just as much as you hate them, they hate you.
I don't hate them.
And the elements shall melt with fervent heat. The earth also and the works that are therein shall be burned up. What the hell? Hold on. Have it in mind.
What scripture is that? What scripture is that? Oh, I had some shit hanging in my nose. What's that? You looking for something?
Yeah.
You know, I got
I got it right here.
I got some. Go ahead. I got a precept for you.
Just brought out.
I got a precept.
People's pants is down.
Yeah, that's disgusting, man. These people are so gone and backward. Walk down the street, pants around a goddamn ankle. You just want to run them over with your car and shit.
What is that you read, though? What is that? 18. Okay, I'm just going to get the same one. Because I got something else. Let's snatch this real quick. Because it's the part where it says in the days of Noah. When the people were just still.
That's in Matthew 24, it says that. Now, let me get this. Are you still searching? Let me get a precept while you're searching.
Go ahead.
The Micah, what was that? Micah 5, I think. Here, let me get this. Micah 4:1. Is this it? No, that's a good point, too, though. What's that mic when it talks about the destruction? Malachi too, we can get that. There's a scripture of Micah when he's talking about he's bringing that fire. I'm gonna get it. Go ahead, bring it out. You got it.
This is Hebrews 11:6. But without faith, this is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to the Most High must believe it that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. By faith, Noah, being warned of the Most High of things not seen as yet, like we're doing, screaming out, and, you know.
Oh, is that, you got Hebrews?
Yeah, Hebrews 11:7.
Yeah, Hebrews 11.
By faith, Noah, being warned of the Most High of things not seen as yet, moved with fear, prepared an ark to the saving of his house, by the which he condemned the world and became heir of the righteousness which is by faith.
Righteousness by faith.
By faith, Abraham, when he was called to go out into a place which he should after receive for an inheritance, obeyed, and he went out, not knowing whither he went. By faith, he sojourned in the land of the promise, as in a strange country, dwelling in tabernacles with Isaac and Jacob, their heirs, with him of the same promise. For he looked for a city which has foundations, whose builder and maker is the Most High. through faith, also Sarah herself, they ain't none of these black bitches, receive strength to receive seed and would deliver.
What about IUIC? They got the daughters of Sarah.
Yeah, right. Oh, Lord.
You ain't seen that?
Nah. Yeah. It's madness, man.
Madness.
They waxing worse and worse.
They ain't nowhere near Sarah.
Right.
Not even close.
Yeah, Sarah had, she was disciplined.
She like Peter said, was it First Peter? Mm-hmm. Sarah called Abraham Lord. Yeah, well, that was her idea. She even suggested that Abraham did, even though she was going off, and they both went off when they had that son Ishmael, thinking he was going to be the son. He was not the son, but yeah, it was her. She's suggesting it. Yeah, you should go ahead and have sex with her and maybe get a baby that way. Just trying to look out for a man was what she was doing.
I can see that happen now.
Yeah, nah, it ain't gonna happen. Yeah, your woman gonna bring you home another woman? Yeah, right. That'd be the best woman ever.
Shit.
If they do it, they wanna have sex with the woman too nowadays. You ain't supposed to be doing that. Two women at once. That's off, man. That's not right.
So it's wearing two different kinds of fabric.
It is. Don't be justifying it.
A woman can't be looking at another woman. Looking at your nakedness.
Exactly, yeah. A woman looking at another woman is. It's like a dude looking at another dude. A woman eating another woman's coochie is just the same thing as a dude sucking another dude's dick. Same thing. You ain't supposed to do that.
Through faith, also Sarah herself received strength to conceive seed and was delivered of a child when she was past age. Because she judged him faithfully who had promised. Therefore sprang there even of one, and him as good as dead, so many as the stars of the sky in multitude, and as the sand which is by the seashore innumerable. Let me find this other scripture.
Yeah, because Israel is more numerous than the sands of the seashore. We the most numerous people on the earth. I got a precept for you. Micah 1:1. It was just 1:1. That's how I couldn't find it. It's right at the top. Micah 1:1, the word of the Lord that came to Micah, the Morashtite, in the days of Jotham, Ahaz, and Hezekiah, kings of Judah, which he saw concerning Samaria and Jerusalem, which is the northern tribes and the southern tribes. Hear, all you people, hearken, O earth, and all that therein is, and let the Lord God be a witness against you, the Lord from his holy temple. For behold, the Lord cometh out of his place, and will come down and tread upon the high places of the earth. And the mountains shall be molten under him, and the valleys shall be cleft as wax before the fire, and as the waters that are poured down from a steep place. For the transgression of Jacob is all this, and for the sins of the house of Israel. What is the transgression of Jacob? Is it not Samaria? And what are the high places of Judah? Are they not Jerusalem? That's the point. So that's why the Lord's going to destroy this place, because of the sins of Israel.
And the grave sin they're committing is ignoring the prophets of the Lord. Not taking heed.
Like, even in America, there's more Israelites than any other nation in this country. We, the Edomites, is running shit. But they're not great number like we are.
It's a giant slave ship.
They're the slave masters over Israel. Just like how Israel was the most numerous in ancient Egypt. That's why the Pharaoh had to say, why they could be coming too numerous. We got to start killing them.
Yeah, them motherfuckers is growing. They was getting scared.
Yeah, that's what the same thing they're doing here in America. Because America's just like a modern day Egypt.
It's modern day.
Yeah, you know, they use the same symbolism. They got pyramids and everywhere on the back of a dollar. Egyptian obelisk in Washington, D.C. You got a Hamite in the White House.
Tex Morrow's got a good-ass video when he's talking about, he's getting close to it, but he is.
He getting into symbolism.
Yeah. Tex Morrow's got a bad video on that, man.
Because Tex Morrow's be going off. You can tell he be eating pork. Yeah. He don't never grow a beard. But there's something in there, and the guy be bringing out truth.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
he hates the hell out of them Jews.
Text Mars.
Yeah, text Mars. If he would have knew about them dietary laws, him and his wife wouldn't be in such bad physical shape. You know, he's always asking people to pray for his wife. She done had 1,000 surgery and they on all kind of medication. And
you know, that's funny how you said that, because I don't never see no videos of him personally. He make videos, but it's always pointed at screens now.
He's too fat.
Yeah.
He's just been sitting there eating all day.
Text Mars.
But I used to always listen, because he got a radio show once a week.
Yeah.
Every Sunday. I might go listen to it when I get home. I ain't listened to it in like 6 months.
Yeah, it's been a minute.
I used to listen to it every week. Because all he talked about is the Jews.
Yeah, he got good people.
Yeah, he gets it in, man. He'll bring out some good information. He made that book, that legendary book, Codex Magica. If you Google Codex Magica. And another one, he had another book too, because he's real good at breaking down the satanic symbolism. You see the other book he had? It's called Mysterious Monuments, I think. I think it's called... And the whole book is about him breaking down the symbolism in structures and buildings.
Yeah, right.
And it shows you how all these government buildings and all these different boarding buildings all around the world are actually satanic temples. And
yeah, he got a good one breaking down Baphomet, showing Baphomet all over the country.
Yeah.
It's actually a badass video, the one on Baphomet, man. It's actually a badass. I can't wait to watch it, man.
So actually, he's put out a lot of information over the years.
You gotta learn how to cipher through it.
Yeah, you gotta cipher through it. Because he's teaching that old Protestant doctrine, you know what I mean?
Chinese. She's beautiful.
Oh yeah, she a Jake. You know she a Jake, she trying to, you know, be all Americanized and shit.
Slut.
She's
still had a heathen ass.
Like a slut
man. Yeah, it ain't really Americanized. What it really is, people don't really want to be like America. They want to be like Jake. That's what it is.
They
want to be like Jake. Jake's the salt of the earth. We got the flavor.
Come over here and start being a motherfucker.
That's why they want to come here. They can't be whores back in their old country. So they'll come here, they get tricked out, they can start making their own pornos.
Free to be a freak.
Go to the clubs, get all the drugs they ever wanted.
Free to be free.
Yeah, the only thing you're free to do in America is to be a faggot. That's the only freedoms you got. And your freedom ends right there.
Free to be a freak.
What's up, man?
Is that American freedom they talk about?
You a great American?
Free to be a fucking freak.
That's the only freedom. You ain't got freedom to travel freely. I was driving home last night up in Whitehall. They had checkpoints all around Whitehall. You couldn't even get in Whitehall.
What?
I had to find a secret entrance into Whitehall.
Whitehall's known for that too, ain't it?
They had checkpoints everywhere. And to go through the checkpoint, they'd be like, let me see your papers or your ID. But I thought this was a free country.
That's Whitehall.
But it's a free country. The Columbus cops did it too. Look, Columbus, they've been doing it on Livingston and Barnett. Columbus cops.
Yeah.
Over in Livingston and Barnett. If this is a free country, how can they set up checkpoints where you can't pass through unless you show some identification?
It's amazing.
But you're free. You're free to travel, right?
Please.
You say, I'm free. I can go wherever I want. Let me see you go through that checkpoint. Let me see you drink a beer then go through that checkpoint.
You in a police state.
Yeah, it's a police state. That's some communist USSR shit. Or to use the old Nazi type shit. When you gotta show your papers. So you is not free in this country. They give you those little bullshit freedoms like, oh, you're free to be a faggot. And they think that's freedom.
They made some progress.
Yeah, that's progress. They think progress is you can be a faggot, so that means you're free. That's not free.
Fucking faggot.
Because you go to work every week. If you're so free, how come you go to work every week and then they take half your paycheck? That's freedom, right? That don't even make no sense.
Freedom is having to pay a $500 fine for health insurance.
And if you don't do what these people tell you, they call themselves the United States government. If you don't do what these people tell you, they come at you with guns, and they will force you against your own will. They'll put handcuffs on you, then kidnap you, and take you away and lock you inside of a cell, inside of a cage.
Behind bars.
And that's if you're lucky. Because really, they could just shoot you right in the head like you did your boy, what's that dude that just got
LaVoy? You see the video yet?
Yeah.
The drone footage?
Yeah.
That's some bad shit.
They shot his ass. Yeah, that was a straight murder.
I loved it, man. I loved it, man. That was some bad shit.
They trying to say he was reaching for a gun?
Yeah, right.
No, they shot his ass and he was grabbing his side.
You see, he did have that interview, though, when he said that I'm not going alive. They're going to have to kill me.
Well, they killed
him. And they probably heard that and was like, you know, okay.
So now they get
hold you to that shit.
They held it. And the Most High held him to it. That's right. The Most High. When you make an oath,
yeah.
Hey, he lived up to his oath.
Yeah.
So when you make an oath before the Most High, he'll hold you accountable to that oath.
Yeah. And just funny, you say that too, cause the militants, that's all they're talking about. They're talking about the FBI and the police.
Yeah.
If you hold your oath, you should fight for this country. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They always say mention it, oath this, the oath that. You know,
I'll get a scripture for that. Them oaths, they swear
oaths
on the
man.
Constitution.
Yep.
You know where that's at, Matthew 5?
Don't want to swear on the Bible or nothing, you know. Don't want to take allegiance to the scriptures or nothing. But that Constitution over
but you,
the scriptures.
You know they all claim to be Christians. They're all, most of them people were Mormons.
Yeah.
I was watching the video. Oh, that dude Pete Santilli, the only reporter out there posting the live feeds.
Right.
They locked his ass up.
Yeah.
And they got him on conspiracy charges. Said he facing 5 years or something.
Hey, Most High's not with him.
And look, exactly. But look, now you can't even get a live feed. You don't even know what's going on in Oregon now. They shut it down. They got a no-fly zone out there now.
They should have, man. But you know what? What's funny is, what they're doing is they're going to have to get outside help if they're going to succeed.
They ain't going
to
get no help.
You know, they're going to have to
get help. They ain't going to get no help.
Right.
It's hopeless. The only help you can get is from the Most High.
Well, the militants, if they are gathered around the country, they're going to have to get, it's going to be outside help that's going to come in that's going to help them out, man.
Man, the militias selling wolf tickets.
Mm-hmm.
They ain't got nothing.
They selling wolf tickets.
Right, and by now, come on, man. The time has been gone.
I still think they're gonna rise.
If they was gonna do something, they would have been in it.
I hope they prove me wrong. I think they're organizing better.
I hope so.
I think they're taking that as an example and they're organizing better, man.
Maybe to be smarter.
I'm hoping.
You think?
Let me say that.
I'm hoping they're organizing better.
Half of them are probably
make
snitches.
A better fight.
They got moles up in there.
Yeah.
But maybe.
The U.S. government is nothing to fuck with.
Because what I see, they got a system of complete and total control in place now.
Yeah.
They ain't getting there or going. It's here now. We're all numbers. Everybody got social security numbers. You're a fucking number. You're an animal. You're tagged cattle.
That's right.
You've been branded.
That's right.
They done stole our children from us. They take your children, rip them away from the families, and send them to some building every day where strangers teach them all kind of garbage every day.
Damn right.
They call it a school.
And here, just two other teachers in Columbus, just got locked up for molesting baby children, man.
Bring that one teacher.
Schools, man.
That one teacher got caught putting sperm in the kids' lunches.
Right. Fucking foul ass.
Anybody that's good with sending their children.
White motherfuckers, man.
Exactly. A bunch of devils.
Goddamn red devils.
Because they the number one problem. Oh, yeah, you know, traitors here.
He just looks like a future school teacher, man.
Probably is.
He just looks like one.
And there's more things coming out all the time about how teachers are molesting the students.
Right.
Child molestation. These motherfuckers
over
here.
Bitches over there smoking
child
a blunt.
Child molestation. And bestiality porn and shit.
He looks like he's all into
it. You ain't seen
right. Like,
one of the top... I seen David Icke, I think it was David Icke that posted it. One of the top judges over there in Britain, one of the top judges. I forget his name, you can look it up.
Right.
I don't know all them faggots' names. But he said that they should drop that age of sexual consent to 4.
Damn. Oh, I just told you before.
And nobody said nothing problem.
No.
Some nigga in Ohio got caught trying to fuck little babies and shit. I think it was like a business or something.
Yeah, right. It's a dude that he was going to seminary school, and he
seminary asked for church, right?
Yeah, and he flew overseas somewhere I can't remember. To have sex with some baby, man. And the FBI was setting him up the whole fucking time, man.
It was probably the FBI. That what do you think the FBI's doing? Oh, the government just came out with footage of the U.S. troops over there. What is it, Iraq? One of them prisons. And it showed you how the U.S. soldiers were raping one of them Arab prisoners, the Muslim prisoners, raping him in his ass. They got it on video. A I think it was in the army or something. And that's how they were tortured. They raped their prisoners in their ass in front of their own mother. That's what this government does, the sanctions.
That's some foul shit.
That's beyond foul.
But hey, Most High wants them to hear this.
you ain't making that up, man. This is the most evil country in the history of the planet Earth.
That's right.
Hey, do you know what the number one murderer of people in the history of Earth is? It's called democide. Get on Google, type in democide, if you know how to spell. Okay, democide is the number one murderer of people in history. It's called death by government. Government is responsible for more murders than anyone else in history. That's a fact. So if you trust the government, you're just a dumbass. People love their oppressors. Y'all proud to be Americans, waving your American flags? Where was the black people when the Constitution was written? What about the Indians? What happened to them? Hey, but they probably got the flags flying too. They so stupid. You know what I mean? You drive through the hood. Hey, you'll drive through the hood. People ain't got no money. Houses falling apart. You know what I'm saying? Them been to jail 20 times. Paying child support. They got American flags flying. That's how stupid they are. They need to be smacked in their damn face.
Psalms 140:1. Deliver me, O Yahweh, from the evil man.
From the evil man. Starting as Esau.
Preserve me from the violent man.
Esau.
Which imagine mischief in their heart. Continually are they gathered together for war.
Esau. Who's continually gathered together for war?
The Edomites.
Edomites. Start with the United States government.
The son of the wicked.
And they said they've been to war 94-95% of the time since they've been
in the country.
And that's ridiculous, man. But that peace is the thing here, though.
You see this truck? Peace
is. And fucking after wars with the Native Americans.
Yep.
That's how you get.
They had giant wars.
There's 200 some trees that broke the Native Americans.
Fucking red devils tell her to go back to Israel.
Yeah, so how you supposed to trust anything the government says after they got a track record like that? Right. The Trail of Tears.
But
that was back then, though.
Yeah.
That was back then, only what? Just a couple years ago. People are fucking stupid, man. People are so gone. You just look in people's eyes, you can just see there's nothing there. They just gone. They've been so brainwashed.
You see the fucking fog?
Yeah.
Is that fog or is that
it was
fucking
a car exhaust.
Pollution?
Yeah, car exhaust. Pollution. Same shit.
The fat bitch farted.
Right.
Oh, that swine.
There you go. This is Ezekiel 24:8. That it might cause fury to come up and take vengeance, I have set her blood upon the top of a rock, that it should not be covered. Therefore, thus said the Lord Power, woe to the bloody city. I will even make the pile for fire great. Heap on wood, kindle the fire, consume the flesh, and spice it well, and let the bones be burned. Then set it empty upon the coals thereof, that the brass of it may be hot, and may burn, and that the filthiness of it may be molten in it.
The filthiness gotta be burned up. You gotta burn the filth.
That the scum of it may be consumed. She have worried herself with lies.
With lies.
And her great scum went not forth out of her. Her scum shall be in the fire. And thy filthiness is lewdness, because I have purged thee. And thou was not purged. Thou shalt not be purged from thy filthiness anymore, till I have caused my fury to rest upon thee.
And that the Lord is going to have his fury rest upon these fools.
Damn right.
And that, with those lies, the lies, that all goes back to the mainstream media, all the propaganda they push. Everything you watch on TV is all fake. And most people, all they do is watch Netflix and TV all day, and they live in an imagination land watching TV shows about shit that never even happened. It's all fictional. They watching fictional realities. And that's all they pump in there. If you pump nothing but fantasy and fiction in your head every day, and that's all your mind consumes, what are you going to think?
Right.
You're going to think, you're going to have fantastical thoughts. You're going to believe in all these lies. Like, you watch all these TV shows, they present all men as being retarded, stupid. And the woman's always the strong one in the family. And all the TV shows, they say it's okay to commit adultery. It's okay to be a faggot in every TV show. So when people, they watch all these TV shows and they watching TV all day, they're being programmed.
Yeah.
That's why it's called television programming.
And it's easy to get these women.
The women, you know, is easy.
Easy.
Yeah.
Hey, dude, when someone,
they watch all that reality shit.
He got to come back. He had to come back.
He was on the phone.
He didn't want to walk to the other bus stop. It's probably too far from the wall.
Probably call the cops on us.
That'd be some holy shit.
Hey, you see what they doing out there in Oregon? They arrest that reporter. Hey, the government, they gonna start silencing people. They ain't the time they gonna start. You gonna hear about more journalists getting locked up, more and more Bible believers getting locked up, getting persecuted, getting shot.
Yeah, yeah.
It's coming, man.
You're not them.
You ain't. There's no freedom of speech no more. They say it's freedom of speech. Hey, trust me, there's no freedom of speech.
Motherfuckers really don't give a fuck about getting locked up.
They don't.
Some of them really don't, man.
They don't.
You can see it in their eyes, man. They want to go out with a fire, man. They want, some of them motherfuckers are really in that
spirit.
That cowboy state of mind.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That wild, wild west state of mind, man. They're going to go out with a fury, man. And personally, I want to see the shit.
I want to see it too.
You know, personally, I want to see it. I want to see a good fight. I want to see a good fight.
You're a man of the Lord ain't supposed to be fighting like that.
Right.
Hey,
right.
But if someone attacks you, hey,
that's for
if someone comes at you with guns, what are you supposed to do?
Right.
You had the right to protect yourself.
Yeah.
You know, against anybody.
Yeah, it's a bad video, man. I hope there's more coming out with that, man. I just hope there is, man.
Because, you know, some people might say we're faggots. You guys are faggots because you're just teaching the Bible. You're not helping out the Patriots. Then fuck the Patriots. That's a lost cause right there. I'm talking about they gonna get America back. What you trying to get back? What part? Oh, if they say America was so great and they gotta get the Constitution back. You know when the Constitution was first written, there was no First Amendment. You know that, right? So why is it called the First Amendment? That means it had to be added to it later. So when they first wrote that goddamn document, they weren't trying to give you no freedom of speech.
Amendment.
And then the other people was like, hold on, wait a minute. Where's our freedom of speech clause at? Oh, you wanted freedom. Oh, we didn't know you wanted that. What's that in? You know?
Amendment.
They was trying to get away with not having that in there.
Right. Look up the word amendment.
Amend. It just means to add, you know, amend.
That's why I'm right.
Yeah, to
right.
Mend. That's why you can mend.
Right there in the name. Right there.
To mend something together.
Yep.
You know?
You
can mend a broken relationship, right?
Ain't there tons of fucking amendments? Like,
yeah, there's all kind of amendments.
Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
But yeah, if this country was so great and the Constitution was the perfect doctrine, then why did it have to be amended on the day they wrote it? If it was perfect from the get, it's a crock of shit, man. That's what it is.
Hey, y'all have any interest in America being destroyed, man?
No.
You better go back to China.
Come here for a minute. What about you, man? You got any interest in America being destroyed?
Love America. You a great American? Fuck America.
He's a great cocksucker.
Right. Fuck him, man.
Fuck him. They love this country, man.
That's right. They sure do. So that means they're enemies of the Most High. This is Ezekiel 20:21. Moreover, the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, now, thou son of man, wilt thou judge? Wilt thou judge the bloody city? Yea, thou shalt show her all her abominations.
And that's what we do. We come out here through the Spirit of the Lord. We show the abominations.
Endless.
It is endless.
It's like you got to shake your head like, ah, damn. And we always come, there's always a new surprise every so often, man, that some new freaky shit comes out and been exposed. People don't give a damn, man. They don't give a damn.
I was just thinking about that. Just some new freaky shit I saw on the news. I'll go ahead. I could come.
Okay. Then say thou, thus saith the Lord Power, The city sheddeth blood in the midst of it, that her time may come, and maketh idols against herself to defile herself. Thou art become guilty in thy blood that thou hast shed. It has defiled thyself in thy idols which thou hast made. And thou hast caused thy days to draw near, and art come even unto thy years. Therefore have I made thee a reproach unto the heathen, and a mocking to all countries.
Yeah, so the near of this country is coming to an end real soon. The Lord's going to destroy this entire country.
Gotta clap for that one.
From sea to shining sea, this shit's going to be burned up.
Gotta clap for that one.
What's that one song? What's that one song? From sea to shining sea. That America?
Right.
America.
And they do make it sound beautiful, man.
Oh, purple mountain majesties, yep. Above the fruited plains. Well, I mean, the country used to be, the land itself is beautiful. It's not the land that's not beautiful, it's the people. These wicked ass people. These worthless ass people. They're worthless, they're useless, they're filthy.
Well, the land too, though, because they shed all
well,
the blood.
Well, yeah, they shed all that blood, you know, on the land.
Shed all the blood.
So they really, yeah, the land is cursed. They defiled the land.
Look at her head on Rachel's body.
Maybe she'll go commit suicide then. She don't care. She got a lot of money in the bank. And what are they going to do when there's a bank holiday? Oh. Soon they're going to have negative interest rates in your banks.
Ooh.
No, they've been this serious talk about it, it's about to happen.
Ooh.
What do you think is going to happen when there's negative interest rates? Negative interest rates.
And all that debt, man, it ain't going to be no government bailing no motherfucker.
Because you know when you get negative interest rates means the bank starts taking money out of your accounts.
That's
they,
right.
They start seizing property.
That's what I was saying, that it ain't going to be no government bailing nobody out.
Nah, hell no.
The people going to have to bail themselves
just
out.
Just like in Cyprus.
Yep. They're going to take your money to get this country out of debt.
I mean, who you think owns the banks in Cyprus?
Right.
The same people that own the banks in America.
Same people.
The so-called Jews. It's the so-called Esau.
Mm-hmm.
They own all the banks in the world. You best believe that. Started with the Rothschilds. They own all the banks.
Hey, y'all got any interest in America being destroyed?
Yo, heathen.
Look, it looked like they were holding hands.
Fucking heathens.
This is Romans 9 and 20. Nay, but, oh man, what? Who art thou that replies against God? Shall the thing formed say to that formed it, why hast thou made me thus? Have not the potter power over the clay, for the same lump to make one vessel to honor and another dishonor. Unto dishonor?
Yeah, so the dishonor vessel was Esau, and the honorable vessel was Jacob. Go ahead.
The third part of man.
Yep.
What if God, willing to show his wrath and to make his power known, endured with much long-suffering the vessels of wrath fits it to destruction?
And that's actually specifically talking about Esau. If you read the whole chapter, he says, Jacob have I loved, but Esau have I hated. Well, he's specifically talking about Jacob and Esau. It's not an interpretation.
Right.
That's what they talk about.
Calling them out, huh?
He called them out. Go ahead.
That he might make known the riches of his glory on the vessels of mercy, which he had afore prepared unto glory.
Which is talking about Israel. Did he say he's going to show mercy? He didn't say thou Lord will show mercy unto Esau. He didn't say that. He specifically told you the mercy was going to Jacob.
See, you know how you be stacking up the cups and you just throw something at it just to destroy it? You know what I'm saying? You just build something up just to knock it down. That's what you do with
it. It's like bowling pins.
That's what
same shit. You go build a sand. You on the beach, some build a sand castle and
it's
shit.
It's going to perish.
Yeah.
But anything you build on the earth is going to perish.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter what it is. Nothing lasts forever.
That was some of the fun shit when we was kids, man. We used to build little houses out of wood and
popsicle
sticks and put firecrackers in them bitches.
I'd blow them up.
Yeah, that was fun. Some fun shit, man.
We used to have Hot Wheel races, put bottle rockets inside of Hot Wheels, and then they shoot off down the street, have races.
I still got bottle rockets from years ago.
Or we just shoot the bottle rockets at each other.
Yeah.
Hey, fuck that.
Real war games, man. It's that fun.
Shit, when we was kids, we used to shoot each other with BB guns.
BB guns, slingshots, all that shit. We used to make our own slingshots.
Oh, yeah, we used to make our own bows and arrows out of rubber bands and
nunchucks.
Oh, you know? I was surprised we survived.
He's right.
Because that was back before all the good video games. We had some video games, but.
Well, you know, the reckless shit we did, the Most High wanted us to come out and do this work, so wasn't nothing going to happen to us.
Yeah.
Imagine if we would have knew that then, though, that we was gonna do this and ain't nothing gonna happen to it. We probably would have been way more reckless, man. Most I would say, I gotta fuck them up.
Man, I done fell out of tree. I used to climb trees all the way to the top just to see how far I could get.
Right.
And that was the last time I ever climbed a tree.
Yeah, I got fucked up riding a bike. And I was going fast as fuck on 10 speed, going downhill too. And check it out, the brake lever slipped off and went into the wheel and tore the spokes. I went flying.
Oh,
fuck. Shit happened to me.
Right.
Remember that? I don't know if y'all remember that, but like by the fifth, whatever, by that railroad track.
Right, overpass or going under the railroad tracks?
Yeah, under one, there's like a big ass hill.
Right.
Yeah, I went down that on the bike. And I hit the rock suddenly, and then I fucking flipped over.
Fucked up.
Yeah.
You ain't break your neck though.
Yeah.
You know?
That's crazy.
Esau would have ended up paralyzed, you know, with his weak bone damage.
Esau will get hurt and go do the same thing again.
Yeah. Oh, hell yeah. Hoping to heal just so he can go do it again, yeah? I'm going to conquer it this time.
They like to go mountain climbing. Like that Google executive that died in that avalanche on Mount Everest.
All that money, man. He had no value of life, man.
Gonna go climbing Mount Everest. You ain't gonna get me on no Mount Everest. No, thank you.
Hell no, man. Hell.
That's a little too far up there.
Hell no. He's so stupid, man.
You know how crazy high up that is?
Yeah.
I'd be scared like a scared little bitch climbing that thing.
So high, they gotta take oxygen with
him. Yeah. You know? Fuck that.
Yeah, fuck that. But Esau, he exercises constantly all day. He running constantly. Got strong-ass lungs and a heart, man. So he can deal with that shit, man.
I seen it when I was in the Marines. All the officers were all Edomites. They punish you on them hikes and stuff. They never got tired. They should be walking and walking. And like, God damn, you gonna slow down?
It's nothing to them, man. It's nothing to them.
Oh, Jake is complaining like, God damn, this motherfucker walking too goddamn fat, because you used to go all them 20-mile hikes, and the officer was always be the one at the front leading the way, be walking fast as hell.
That shit do sound fun to me.
That is not fun. Ain't nothing fun about it.
I've always loved that shit, man.
I mean, it's fun to an extent, but after the 10th mile or so, boy, you get them blisters on your feet, boy. After a while, you get so many blisters, your whole foot just turns into a giant callus. My feet still got, it's still hard as a rock.
That's what it does.
So I don't even get blisters no more.
Yeah.
I mean, some of it might have been kind of fun, but. You got something you want to bring up?
Yeah, let's go to that scripture he's reading by Esau. This is the definition. Well, this is just on Edom. Bible dictionary. Edom figures prominently in the prophetic scriptures as a scene of great future judgment. She is the only neighbor of the Israelites who was not given any promise of mercy from the Most High. And you know, like the book of Revelation says that when the Most High come and fuck them up, they can still be cursing out the Most High.
Yeah, there's that. You
know, they can still.
It's just like when the Pharaoh. When the Most High was jacking up the Pharaoh, and it said the Most High hardened the Pharaoh's heart. You know what I'm saying? Even though the Pharaoh was getting fucked up, they was getting plagued, he was still talking shit.
Still talking shit.
Because the Most High did that to him.
Hold on, here we go. I think this is it. Oh, here we go. It is 9:20. 9:21, 9:20, and the rest of this Revelation 9:20, and the rest of the men which were not killed by these plagues, yet repented not of the work of the hand of their hands, their wicked shit, and oppressed the children of Israel, dealing with the children of Israel wickedly, taxing them.
Taxing them, locking them up.
Right.
Taking their children away, shipping them off to school.
Yet repented not of the works of their hands, that they should not worship devils and idols of gold and silver and brass and stone and of wood, which neither can see nor hear nor walk. Neither repented they of their murders, nor of their sorceries, nor of their fornications, nor of their thefts. That was it on that. So this is what we're going to have to beat them into, beat them into repentance. You know, we're going to be beating the shit out of them, and then all of a sudden they're going to start screaming out the Lord's name. The Lord ain't going to do nothing for them, though. They're Edomites. I can't wait to start beating them, man. I'm talking about beating them. Beating them. And I don't want to do no spiritual shit like using spiritual power. I want to do it with my fucking bare hands, man.
We're going to go to that cliff and start tossing them off
the
cliff.
Right, right. So you can toss them the most.
Then maybe they like Mount Everest so much, we can take a trip to Mount Everest.
Hell yeah. You know.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, they like climbing mountains.
Shit, we could take them right up to the top of that bitch and throw their ass off.
They like jumping off the motherfuckers, gliding off of them, too.
Let's see if they can learn how to fly.
You know, they put them... they are having some fun, though. You got to admit, man. They put them fucking gliders in. They be gliding just forever, man. Just be gliding.
They got a lot of fail videos on YouTube. where the glider don't work or the parachute don't pop out. The bungee cord snaps.
When keeping it real, boss.
Now those videos are endless on YouTube, man. I watched them with my son. I was like, this is why you don't do this stuff.
Yeah. Tempted the Most High.
Yeah, you tempted the Most High. That's good though. They deserve to perish. I seen this video of this bitch, man. She went to bungee jump. And all you heard before she hit the bottom was, ah! She screamed and then nothing. Silence. You could just hear the terror in her voice. It's like, it wasn't even funny when you watched. I was like, wow, that was fucking creepy.
Like, thousand faces of death. Dude jumped off the building with the bungee cord that was too long.
Yeah.
All the dudes on top of the building were laughing.
They were laughing until they went down there. I think that was fake, though, wasn't it?
No, I thought that was all real.
Faces of death?
Some of that shit in there looks fake.
Yeah.
I think it's like, I think they re-dramatized some of it. Yeah, that was some gruesome shit. Smoking a blunt.
Some of these hoes didn't wait for a man to say something to
them. That's probably what it was. Okay, he's like, that we got it.
Lick the cream out her coochie.
Black woman, too. Black woman got a husband. They still can't wait till another man holler at that bitch, man.
Yeah, because we walk in and they be trying to, like, you know, close to you and shit. Mm-hmm. You should say something.
And the funny thing, they act like they don't want you to talk to them, but you can tell they do, though.
I'll be at the grocery store, and they'll try to just start up a conversation with you. Like, which one should I get, this one or that one?
What's up, man? You a great American?
Nope.
Oh, I heard that. My man.
You stinking pretty.
My man.
Got your head on straight.
My man.
He said nope.
My man, the way Denzel said, my man.
Yeah, my man.
The fact that it's Denzel. So I can't wait till the Most High fuck him up, man. Him and Michael Jordan, man. And I believe we're going to see some amazing shit this year. Watch. We already seen some crazy shit.
You see all these famous people dropping dead lately?
Yeah. Nobody expected David Bowie to drop like that, man.
First it was Lemmy. Lemmy started it.
Scott Weiland.
Huh?
Scott Weiland.
Oh, yeah. Scott Weiland came first, didn't he? Oh, yeah. Scott Weiland. Then came Lemmy. Then David Bowie. The dude from Jefferson Airplane just dropped dead.
Yeah.
Somebody else big just died too.
Yeah, no, a country dude and another rock dude. I can't remember the names though.
Oh, the dude from the Eagles, Glenn Fry.
Yeah, right, right.
All kind of, it's the season, man, of death.
Hey. Like I said, I think we're going to get us a big treat, man. Something that we're going to get drunk as hell to. Shit.
The BMA is going to get blown
David
up.
David Bowie, man, that was a big fucking faggot, man.
And everybody, they lamented over David Bowie.
And one thing they brought out, and they talked about it like it was just a great achievement and accomplishment, that he was fucking Mick Jagger, man.
That was an accomplishment. His greatest life's greatest achievement.
You're a big fucking faggot.
And you ever listen to some of his latest work, that last album he made?
The one that's about to drop?
Black Star? It's some straight...
I know, I heard all this shit.
It's some straight weirdo music.
Yeah.
I know he got some good shit.
That shit is bad as fuck.
He's a good musician.
Very good musician.
But he's just a fucking weirdo.
He's a jake, though.
Yeah, he's a jake.
I watched Labyrinth like the day before he died.
You see his wife, right? See his wife? The model bitch, the black
woman. Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Fine as hell.
Married to his sister.
Well, before he was with, God damn it, what's love got to do with it?
Cindy Lauper.
What's love got to do with
it? Damn.
Tina Turner.
Tina,
yeah. That's a dope.
Yeah, he was hitting it. He was hitting it.
He was with her for a minute. They did the Coke commercials together back in the 80s.
Tina was fucking everything.
That's adultery too, dude, because that pussy belonged to Ike.
Yeah.
Bitch's last name is Turner.
That's right. Ain't that crazy, man? Open adulterous, man.
And they just open with it.
Open, yeah. And married two other motherfuckers still got.
And then they demonized Ike Turner. That's he was the bad guy.
Right.
How's he lost his wife? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, them last three albums I came out with.
He should have pulled out O.J.
Nice
Simpson.
Shit, he won that big-ass award. He won the Jazz Album of the Year or the Blues Album of the Year. Like 2003, 2004, something like
that. Oh, for real?
Yeah, Ike Turner.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, Ike's still doing his shit, man.
I'm about to check that out.
Yeah, Ike Turner bad, man. Ike Turner never stopped doing his shit.
Yeah, I didn't know that.
And he wicked as hell.
Hey, he wicked as hell.
Wicked as all fucking hell. I mean, come on, in order for them to take him back in and start making money, he had to sold his soul, man.
Probably had to,
do some extra shit to get back in, man. Oh, that's a nigga of all motherfuckers. Ike Turner. Just look at him, man. You can see the man evil. Ike Turner, he got a mean looking mean.
He probably was mean.
Hell yeah. But, I mean, that's his woman how he was treating Tina, though. Ain't nobody's business.
Ain't nobody's business.
Right. Nobody, no matter how, if he was beating her ass or not, it's his business.
Oh, yeah,
and that black bitch probably deserved her ass good.
She probably did, too.
He probably saw the bitch about to go off and do her own thing with them motherfucking Edomites.
Yep.
She's
like, here it is. I took this bitch.
He's a big man. He play football, man. My man, which position? My man.
Here it is. He brought this bitch out of nowhere. He the one who made her big.
He gonna have a bad season because she should have stopped. Should have stopped.
What did he say? He's a center?
Offensive tackle.
Tackle? He looked like a fucking tackle. Dude is huge. Yeah, damn. I don't want nobody like saying, you gotta be crazy to play football against these big motherfuckers. Oh shit, what the hell?
Just imagine that in 20 years. This on the
that was a motherfucker.
Like,
they gonna like my booty. They
gonna
like mine.
Crazy ass Israelite bitches.
I'm gonna hit that shit. Oh no.
She gonna go home and tell everybody about that.
Yeah, they like me. No, we didn't.
Yeah, sometimes you don't try to say nothing, but sometimes you get surprised by something. You're like, wow.
Yeah, right. But what's Tina turning into now, man?
I know the bitch was still alive.
Yeah, Kabbalah or...
Yeah, she looked like a witch.
Scientology.
She's into...
She probably is a Scientology.
Nah, she's a monk.
A monk.
A Buddhist.
A Buddhist. She's into all that crazy shit.
Everybody's
man.
What's
that Madonna's into?
She's a Kabbalah.
Kabbalah, that's what she's into.
That's that Jew shit.
Yeah, look at that.
All the famous people's into the Kabbalah.
Yeah, ain't that crazy? They get money, man, and just go crazy, man. Let's lose their goddamn mind, man. Everything become enlightenment to them. Everything, man. They got a little bit of every goddamn thing, man. They can just straight up vomit, man. Straight up vomit. You and vomit shit, you don't recognize nothing, but you just see that.
And if somebody tells you, say they into Buddhism, I'm like, well, tell me about Buddhism. And then they're like, come on, tell me something. Tell me something.
Right,
I just like it.
Yeah, give me some enlightenment.
Yeah, what do you like about it? Right. It's peaceful. Really? I mean, what is Buddhism? What is that? What is it? It's nothing.
there's a temple they go to, man. It's on the side of a river, man. They in these steep ass steps.
You want to take a picture of it? I seen that.
Man, it's a huge. It's bigger than a. It's like a skyscraper.
Cause they built a temple. Cause originally it was. I forget. I studied that history years ago. I was getting into the history. Cause I believe a lot of them famous Buddhas were Jakes. Because even the Buddha statue itself is based upon Hellenistic art. The Buddha is the popular image of a Buddha you see with all the jewelry and all that. That all goes back to the image of the Greek Apollo. Because what happened is Alexander the Great, you know, about 300 BC, he conquered all those. He went as far. He almost went, pretty much went to China almost. It was way over there. So they brought their artwork and styles with them. They brought Apollo with them. They brought, what's Apollo's sister's name? Fucking not Artemis. Artemis. They brought all their gods with them, right? And so that's why the later Buddhist artwork reflects the Greek artwork. So, you know, there's all kind of Israelites over there in China because the Greeks were Israelites.
It's Israel that know how to do all that big, huge, extensive sculpturing.
Yeah, that was Israel's artwork. I mean, they was famous for it. Why do you think the Lord said, I'm going to destroy your idols?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
And they make those idols so lifelike, you think they're real. They look real. You're like, oh, shit. Like the one we was looking at downtown?
Oh, yeah.
That shit is creepy. You can see why a heathen or a retarded Israelite would start worshiping it. Because it looks so lifelike, you know? It looks so real.
Ain't got no breath, can't get up to save itself.
We got none.
You know? Can't do shit for you. Can't do shit for itself. But people lose sleep if they don't drop and worship that shit, man.
Well, nowadays, they don't have the big statues they worship no more. Nowadays, they just use their little crosses and good luck charms and, now the idols are the American idols. Your celebrities.
American Idol, sure.
It's called Idol. American Idol.
Maybe Ford Austin. What's up, man?
Because you know the word idol comes from the word, that's idol, eye, from your eye. Alright? So these people worship what they see. Hey, I'll get it. These people worship.
You find me an idol scripture.
All right, I'm going to get this scripture because it breaks.
Thou shalt not have no false idols.
What's that? 19, 20.
What is it?
Exodus. He's quoting the Ten Commandments.
Yeah,
Exodus 20. I was about to get 1 John. Because this scripture right here sums it up perfectly. This wicked ass fucking world, man. Fucking. Here we go. 1 John. Well, I just started. This is one of my favorite scriptures in the whole Bible. I want to read all of it, though. 1 John 2 and 15. Love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him. So we don't love this world. We hate this world. You know what I'm saying? We pray the Lord destroys this world. All right? And the scripture clearly says, whoever loves this world, the love of the Father is not, N-O-T, is not in him. It says, for all that is in the world is this. Look, this is what's in the world. All that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life is not of the Father, but is of the world. So that's all that's in this world is what? The lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, what they see, what they can touch. That's all they care about. That's it. They're simpletons. They're carnal.
Shit. Okay, yeah. Scripture that says the kingdom
might
of
well
heaven
finish
is not,
that.
It's not quite. The Pharisees came up to the Lord and said, when the kingdom coming, he said, it's not with observation. It's not going to say here and there or there.
He said the kingdom of heaven is inside of you. Even though there will be a physical kingdom one day, but first the kingdom's got to be inside of you.
You can't see it. You got to.
It's inside of you. Right. You got to have faith.
Having spiritual power is having this wisdom.
Yeah, because really right now in our spirits, we're in the kingdom because we got this truth.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. That's right.
Just like people say,
is where it starts from.
Like they can, all like Paul said, what's that in Timothy? Is that Timothy or Titus? And he said, I'm bound, but the word of the Most High is not bound.
Right.
I mean, you can lock me up in prison, but you can't lock up the word of the Most High.
That's right. That's right.
You can't bound. What scripture is that? I'm going to look it up.
That's probably why, one of the main reasons why a lot of us brothers don't go to jail. A lot of the elect that's out doing the work, we don't go to jail because we might, you know, get them prisoners.
Oh, that'd be too much for
them. Yeah.
Hey, even though Dave got locked up, maybe he's in there giving them a lot of stuff.
He probably done turned Muslim.
Dave ain't going to turn into a Muslim.
Yeah. Hey.
He better.
Don't say it won't. Don't say that. You know, because we hit with surprises all the time.
Hey, the RZA turned into a Muslim.
We hit with surprises all the time, man. Now, it bugged us out. Like, come on. The motherfucker that was on the comic board that said that he's
dope.
No, he's from the tribe of Judah, but he's in
a Muslim.
There you go.
He's
so
like,
don't be surprised that happened.
Yeah,
man.
That's bugged out, dude. This dude actually said, I was talking for the camera. I was talking to this guy on YouTube, and he told me he was a Muslim, but he believed in Yahushua, called the Lord by his Hebrew name.
He knew he was of the tribe
of Judah.
Yeah.
He said Yasharallah and all that, but he was still a Muslim.
Yeah, right. He said, and I reached on some of the sky, how he
where
was
did
thinking,
they get that?
Right. I mean, I'm tripping, man.
You really will trip after you feel like that.
Like I said, man, don't be surprised. People we used to rap with, man, kick it with, man.
Well, I'm not saying anybody. I just don't see Dave doing that.
I see Dave doing a lot worse.
I see him getting worse. But I think deep down inside, he believes in the truth.
Nah, I don't believe it at
all.
I just think
I don't believe he believes it at all.
I think he believes that he can get away with whatever he wants.
Hey, Julian says his sister's at home watching GMS videos all day. Dave's wife.
Watching GMS videos?
Yeah, I doubt that.
I don't know.
That's an evil bitch, man. You met her?
No.
That's an evil hoe, man. That's the definition of an evil black bitch, man. That bitch is fucking with me, man.
Whoa.
She came in the house several times I was over there, and she cussed all them niggas out. And I know why she was doing it. She was probably trying to get with me. you know what I mean? Trying to impress me and shit.
Because, the woman's mind is wicked, man.
Yeah, she's evil, man. She cussed all them motherfuckers out, man. Look at that big-ass balloon bear over there, man.
Because that's actually the last woman... Yeah, that was Macy Gray. Hey, that's the woman...
God damn.
That, if you got a woman... on YouTube with her names like what's a popular Sarah Yasharallah, her last name's Yasharallah or Yisrael.
Yisrael.
I don't give a stay away from those hoes. They're nuts. They're whack jobs. Whack jobs. I don't care. I mean, it's beautiful, you know, you're an Israelite, but get your crazy ass away from me. Okay. They gonna try to teach you.
The bitches ain't in churches and shit.
And they be the main ones on the comment boards. Just type something this goddamn long.
Bitch,
y'all
teach me on Facebook. I don't know you can be teaching. Yeah, she try to argue with me and shit. I try to teach this bitch, she can't teach.
And then they posted selfies all day.
Telling other girls to leave their husbands.
Selfies of their butt turned to the...
But then they'll brag about, I got my head covered. And then they're making that like they're bragging, my head's covered. I got the nicest headscarf.
Yeah, but the camera, they butt his face toward the camera with them looking backwards.
Oh, there you go. That's
what they do, too.
That's off.
That's what they do, too. Remember the old black bitch that came out here?
Hey.
I follow all the laws.
Hey, man, if you got...
Walked off?
Yeah, right.
Yeah, If you got a woman... You better, you ain't gonna stop her, but make sure she shouldn't have no accounts on no channel on no internet. Yeah. Fuck anybody who she can get.
That's right. That's probably good.
Do you know how dangerous Facebook is for a wife?
You know how many dudes fucking hound dog bitches on Facebook?
Exactly. You got that chat, you can send people messages all day. If you're a woman and you got pictures on Facebook, you getting 1,000 messages a day.
I seen Lauren's phone one day before she got off of Facebook. She had like 40 notifications in like an hour.
Just getting offered dick left and right.
I told her to get off of all of the shit and she did.
That's funny, your dude Derek won't let his girl have Facebook. She ain't even allowed to leave the house.
My why we could even go in Lump Face. She never wanted to be on that shit. She never wanted to.
That's good. Yep. Shit.
But then again, she probably don't want to because she got shit to hide. You know what I'm saying? She might be exposed. She might get exposed.
I like the way like, you know,
it shows your it shows your location. Like, if you post something and be like, West Side, Columbus.
Damn.
That's just dangerous. Really, it is all Facebook is a... That's an easy way for law enforcement to find out what you're doing.
It would tell how long ago you was online, like last act of 5 minutes ago.
Of course.
Yeah, it's the best video.
I remember years ago they said, but all the internet's like that.
What's up, man? Where you from, man?
India.
Where you from? Pakistan.
Oh no, Sri Lanka.
Who?
Sri Lanka.
Sri Lanka.
Oh, really? Sri Lanka. The military's there. Yeah.
Is that East India?
Elon Musk.
Mm-hmm. You talk about a goofy spirit.
They be talking funny as hell.
Yeah, that was a goofy one. Man. That was a real goofy. I was surprised he even.
Sri Lanka is down there by India. It's not.
No, they're nice as fuck.
Down at the bottom.
Sri Lanka.
That's a weird place right there. You don't want to go down there.
Like a Spaniard.
You about to go play soccer, dude?
It looks like Prince William's cousin.
Yeah, gay porn star.
He looked like he had that Esau spirit.
Yeah.
Ooh,
look at that.
You can tell it's one of the more thoroughbred Edomites. I know an Esau when I see Esau.
Hey, he's running whatever hard times they run into when they go to college, they can go right back home and live comfortable, man. That's, and mom and dad embrace them in like, baby, you ain't.
So that's one of them. That's one of the bad Edomites, the more tougher Edomites we was talking about. But not all the Edomites are all faggots.
Some of them
are just straight killers.
They're straight up rough.
Straight rough. They might be faggots, you know, like, fuck, they dudes are rough, they are killers.
Like Amalek, he's vicious.
Yeah, he was.
He's vicious.
He's more vicious mentally.
Mm-hmm. Right.
He's more devious.
He's intelligent.
Intelligent.
He's more intelligent.
He gets you with his intelligence.
Yeah, yeah. A killer.
Yeah, then you got the other tribes.
He's vicious, man. They are vicious, man. Vicious. That bloody city, boy. This is their mind. The bloody city is their mind. It's their mind manifested physically.
Wow. He just blew my mind. He said that this world is Esau. Say that again.
Esau's mind is manifested. It's his mind manifested physically.
This is it. That's right. This is Esau's mind manifested physically.
Right, right. And it gets worse. And it's going to get worse.
That's a perfect way to put it, too.
That's
it really is. This
that's
is
right. That's
we're
right.
Living inside of Esau's mind right here.
Yep.
Is his mind.
Trapped up in the matrix.
A system of total control and enslavement.
That's right.
Is what we live in.
That's right.
That's a perfect way. I'm going to use that again, man. That's a perfect way to say it.
Esau.
That is a perfect way to explain it.
Into the hands of the wicked.
Oh, here it is. Look. 2 Timothy. Let me get that. 2 Timothy 2:9. But I know there's more meat to it than just that.
He got this shit locked down. People just don't understand how much he got it locked
like
down.
We said, Esau can only lock down what he can touch.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you can't grab a hold of this word.
Yep.
You cannot lock this word up and throw the Holy Spirit in a prison.
That's right. That's right.
You can't do it. It ain't gonna happen. So, like, the weapons of our warfare are not carnal.
Now,
you can't stop these weapons that we got. It's like, because people get on us because, you know, we're not taking up arms. And these other people is saying that we're not doing it. They're not doing that either. They're just saying that up behind a keyboard.
That's all.
You know what I mean?
That's
all. Stockpiling food.
Like, everybody talks shit about those patriots, like, out in Oregon. Say, won't y'all start shooting? Won't you go help them?
I see your ass.
You ain't doing nothing either. You're talking shit on a computer.
Yeah.
And we definitely ain't going to do that.
Can I read this real quick?
I'll go ahead.
This is 1 Corinthians 2:9. But as it is written, I have not seen, nor ear heard, neither have entered into the heart of man the things which the Most High have prepared for them that love him. Wow, that's like.
Yeah.
Most High has revealed them unto us by his Spirit. For the Spirit searches all things, yea, the deep things of the Most High. For what man knoweth the things of a man, save the spirit of a man which is in him? Even so the things of the Most High knoweth no man, but the Spirit of the Most High. Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the spirit which the most, which is of the Most High, that we might know the things that are freely given to us of the Most High, which things also we speak, not in the words which man's wisdom teacheth, but which the Holy Spirit teaches.
What the Holy Spirit teaches. That's why I say Esau, the government, the cops. The cops can't arrest the Holy Spirit. We were taking you to jail.
Put you in a bottle off his Zelda.
Yeah, you can't arrest. You can arrest us. You know, you can't arrest the Holy Spirit. You can't contain it.
That's right.
That's the only thing we got. That is the only thing that we got.
And that's
the most powerful weapon on earth.
It's the only weapon most high.
Tell me, it's the most powerful weapon.
That's right.
It really is. It's how.
Right.
Yeah, because if you ain't got no faith in that, you ain't gonna believe in it.
Yeah. They don't see that. They, like you say, they gotta touch it, be able to feel it, and be able to have an actual gun with a 1,000-round clip in it. But this spiritual, this weapon that the Most High gave us, man,
it's like
you gotta use it with faith. It's like that chip they gonna put in guns to use the gun that you can't. If you don't got the chip, you can't shoot that gun.
Because we changing the way people, we ain't doing shit, the Most High is doing it. Through the Spirit of the Most High, we change the way people's minds are operating.
That's right, spiritual power.
Because we could change the way a cop thinks, and he might say, fuck this shit, I'm not doing this no more.
That's spiritual power.
That's spiritual power.
Yeah.
That's operating on what they call a metaphysical level.
That's right.
On a spiritual level.
Yep.
We affect things spiritually.
Yep.
And then the spirit affects the physical world.
That's right.
It's the spirit that controls the physical world.
Little and small examples of spiritual power.
That is definitely spiritual
now,
power.
Now listen, before we started coming out here teaching, there wasn't nothing going on in the country, man.
Nope.
Then the prophets started coming out, posting up, building camps all over the world, man. Then the whole vibration.
You know what changed. I see? I seen a woman complaining today. I forget where I seen it. She was complaining because most men now have beards. They say there's a big trend with men having beards now.
Yeah.
You know?
They just hate that shit.
I've heard of like the sales of razor blade companies have been going down. Just little things like that show you how the times are changing.
Remember I told your mom I want to grow a beard. She's like, honey, you too cute. You too gorgeous for that. Don't do that.
My mom said that?
Yeah.
Sounds like something a woman would say.
Yeah.
These women are gone. My girls always tell me that. People always tell me, you would look so cute without. No, right. I would. I would look like a goddamn milk dud. Bald ass head and a bald ass face.
Right. Women crazy.
I would look fucking retarded without a big beard. I would feel naked.
Without a beard.
I ain't already got no hair.
I can imagine how vexed your spirit would be. You cut your
beard off. Yeah, I love my beard. I like caressing it.
You'd be walking the streets paranoid that the Most High drop a brick on your ass.
I can't stop fucking with my beard.
You shave your beard, you might be walking, most of the time I drop a plane on your ass. Well, that's what you get. That beard is going to get you killed, buddy.
Oh,
Same thing with these people in the world. They want stupid shit, and they're going to keep on doing it until, you know, until that time comes when they know they should stop. It don't work that way. They're going to just keep on doing their wicked shit until that time comes.
I got a scripture. 2 Timothy 2 and 7. Consider what I say, and the Lord give thee understanding in all things. And that's the truth. It said, remember that Yahweh Shai Mashiach of the seed of David was raised from the dead according to my gospel. So, what he said, of the seed of David. What is that? That disproves the virgin myth right there. We ain't even got to go into it. It says, wherein I suffer. This is Paul. Remember, Paul wrote this while he was in prison. Okay? He said, wherein I suffer trouble as an evildoer, even unto bonds, but the word of God is not bound. So check it out. He said he suffers trouble as an evildoer. I mean, he's locked up in the same place where they put murderers and rapists and child molesters.
They don't even get put in there.
Well, right nowadays they don't. But he got locked up like he was an evil one, man. You know what I'm saying? And he was just teaching the word of the Most High. They locked him up and killed him for it. He actually got the Emperor Nero put him to death. He even tells you in here he had to go before the Emperor Nero. Let's see if I can find that. I think it's at the end of Timothy, ain't it? It mentions Nero by name. Yeah, look. This the very last scripture. It's 2 Timothy, was at 4:22. The Lord Yahweh Shai be with thy spirit. Grace be unto you. Amen. The second epistle unto Timotheus, ordained the first bishop of the church of the Ephesians, was written from Rome when Paul was brought before Nero the second time. So it mentions the Emperor Nero by name. Huh. But since the Bible's, people will say the Bible's is not real, so I guess that means Nero never lived, right?
Exactly.
Even though Nero's famous for killing Christians, there's proof right there.
Well, Pharaoh never existed.
Yeah, because Nero is evil as hell, man. For real, Paul said, though, Paul said he was locked up just like an evildoer was locked up. But he didn't ever do nothing evil, right? Well, he did before he's converted, but he said, I'm bound, but the word of the Most High is not bound. That's some good shit right there. Because you can't contain the word of the Most High. You can't contain the spirit. And it's not going to happen.
Yeah, it's too late for that.
It's too late. It's out. It's the spirit. You can't grab a hold of a spirit.
He saw some of them dollar signs from the internet, the money you're going to make from the internet. He just totally, he wasn't thinking. He wasn't in his right sense.
Just like the Pharaoh wasn't thinking.
Yeah.
Most High, he's controlling everything, man.
Firmament. The unicorn. That's some powerful stuff.
That is some powerful. You guys got me thinking on the Holy Spirit right now. You can't contain it. You can't stop it.
Yeah.
That's all I can think about right now. Gave me some hope. You be hopeless out here. There's some hopeless ass shit we living in here, man.
Woo.
Every day shit gets worse.
That's what it feels like.
We live just in a giant pile of shit, and all you see is just...
And it don't feel good, too.
Everyone's miserable. Everybody's getting waxed. You're getting taxed. Taking all your money. Cops fucking with you every second they can. There's always a new bullshit law getting passed every day, taking away more of your freedoms, more of your rights. Congress is putting a martial law bill through the Senate. You see that?
Yeah, that's
what I'm saying. And it's not even on the news. Nobody talks about it.
Personally, I think them delaying people's income tax has a lot to do with something they're doing.
Oh, man, I hope. Lord, please just cancel income tax returns.
Right. Yeah.
Oh my Lord, that would be so beautiful.
But the thing is, I think that when they delaying it, because
is it really getting delayed?
It's actually, people should be getting their shit now.
Really?
They're not, you know? I think they're going to just wait, start giving the people money, so when they start spending and going to the bars and clubs.
All that kind of economy be helped out.
Yep. I think they're going to pass that while people having a good time and thinking they're country's making it, they're going to pass something, man. Something's going to pass. People ain't looking for enlightenment any motherfucker.
Well, these people don't know anything about politics anyway.
Right, they ain't looking for nothing anyway.
They can't tell you the three branches of government. Most people don't know the three branches of government.
The three branches.
They can't even find Ohio on a map. You know what I'm saying?
Executive, legislative, and judicial. I know that.
Congratulations. hey, you just... prove to me that you're smarter than most people. Now you had some branches of government. Was it a tree? How many senators are there?
Something depends on what state.
There's two senators per state. Every state.
I'm thinking Congress.
Yeah, Congress. Go ahead.
2 Corinthians 5:1. For we know that if our earthly house of this tabernacle were dissolved, we have a building of God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens.
That backs up the Holy Spirit right there, because what? The Spirit's everywhere. Read that again. The Spirit is everywhere. You can't contain it. Go ahead.
2 Corinthians 5:1. For we know that if our earthly house of this tabernacle was dissolved, we have a building of God, a house not made with hands, eternal in heaven.
Eternal in heaven.
With this we run, earnestly desiring to be clothed upon with our house, which is from heaven. If so be that being clothed, we shall not be found naked. For we that are in this tabernacle do groan, being burdened, not for that we will be unclothed, but clothed upon, that mortality might be swallowed up of life. Now he have wrought us for the self-same thing.
My fault.
Okay.
Get it out of here.
self same thing as God, who also have given unto us the earnest of the Spirit. Therefore, earnest of the Spirit. That's the only ones that's fucking want the kingdom.
Yeah, right.
Now he that have, I read that. Therefore, we are also always confident, knowing that.
Look at these devils. Look, get him on camera. Who is that?
Fire department.
They're just as bad as the cops.
Damn, it's
just because they don't shoot nobody. They trust me. Part of Masonic brotherhoods, fraternities. The fireman's symbol is the Knights Templar symbol. Yep. Go ahead with that. Is that it?
No. Therefore, we are always confident, knowing that which we are at home in the body, we are absent from the Lord, is the point. For we walk by faith, not by sight. We are confident, I say, and willing rather to be absent from the body and to be present.
Yeah, we walk by faith, not by sight. Don't mean we walk around with our eyes like walk around like this. No. But you know, some people might think that.
Probably could.
But you know, most people, they don't think with a spiritual mind like that. You know what I'm saying? That's what we walk with, a spiritual
look,
mind.
Look, he walked back there this time.
You know, Esau?
He looks like somebody out there.
He looks like a child molester, don't he?
Yeah, he looks like a rapist child, but he done did it all. He's still doing it all.
Esau.
He looks wicked. Man.
Esau's just a big fucking weirdo.
Yeah, big freaky creep.
I hate these faggots.
A vile. Based.
He's a lowlife. He's a serpent. Just like the scripture said, the serpent was going to be the lowest animal in the field, didn't it?
Yeah.
He's going to crawl on his belly his whole life. As Esau. He's profane. He slithers around. He's just slithering.
But we supposed to love him though. Sheep. They gonna make it to the kingdom.
Fucking want to punch him in the fucking face.
They will make it to the kingdom.
Kick them.
They'll be in the kingdom.
Right.
Smash their fucking head.
They're getting beat. You know. Cleaning the fields. They're gonna be way out too. You're gonna hear them screaming and shit. Then you gotta get the devil screaming because that's noise. Shit.
It's gonna be like that movie Blazing Saddles. Your boy's like, we're gonna do a number six on him. You know about the number six? He's like, that's when we go riding into town, a romping and a whooping, killing everything in sight.
Right.
And he's like, what about the women? You spare the women? He's like, hell no, we raped the shit out of him. I always get that. I'm going to get that scripture.
Shit, man. That motherfucker in trouble, man. And he know it, too. That's what's funny. The elites know it.
They do know.
They know it.
That's why they keep passing on these new laws and they tightening down control with this police state.
Yeah, they about to come with it.
Why you think they have these cops set up barricades and fucking stops everywhere?
I'm not surprised Whitehall's doing that, man, because Whitehall's known to be dickhead at cops, man.
That's the first time I seen that, man.
Hey.
Yeah, they known to be slimy.
Let me holler.
Like, come last time I bashed your crib, left your crib drunk that one night, man. This motherfucking cops are just pulling out behind people.
Yeah, they hide. They hide
in
the
crutches, man.
Bexley be like that even worse. Bexley, I see the Bexley cops. You got to watch your ass driving
through
Bexley.
I don't go through Bexley.
If I do, I go down Broad Street. Because the only way to get to the east side, you ain't got but three ways.
Right.
Really? Well, it is. To get it, because you got to cross that river. You got to go across the bridges.
Not to the main street.
I'm going to get that scripture. Is that. Man. I'm going to find it. I was just reading the other day. Man, I'm having. I can't remember scriptures to save my life. I've been reading too much. That's what this technology is for. I memorized one scripture.
They're gonna come to all of us, man. We're gonna summon certain Edomites. They're gonna come and bow down to us while we're sitting in our little gold chairs.
Like, you'll have dudes try, they won't try to get Esau to bow to him in this kingdom.
Right.
When you go home, you're still in slavery.
Still in slavery. Right.
Still in slavery.
Right. There's some good videos, though, like the times Edomites did bow.
Yeah. But they want to do it for their own personal glory, usually. What's this at? Check this out. 1 Kings 11 and
Is this motherfucker coming back again?
Oh, he's gone. I hope he don't come over here with a throw feces at us.
You have a spray bottle full of sperm and spray it on us.
Let me read this.
Like inside of the land when Goldberg went to the prison to talk to dude when she was leaving Hannibal
Nut at her. Oh man, that's foul. That's probably true too. I bet shit like that happens all the time.
She probably did like that shit.
Yeah, they don't come up with that shit. They just
Jodie Foster. Wait, sexy redhead.
She was hot way back in the day. I don't know about now.
She thick.
Is she?
Yeah, she curvy, man. She's a lesbian anyway.
She looked like a lesbian. Let me read this. There ain't gonna be no lesbians in the kingdom of heaven. 1 Kings 11 and 15. See, this is what King David did when he was on the earth, okay? For it came to pass when David was in Edom and Joab, the captain of the host, was gone up to bury the slain after he had smitten every male in Edom. Now it specifically said he smitted. Is that a word? He killed every male in Edom. So why did it specifically say male? So what do you think they did with the women?
What?
They didn't, they didn't kill the women. They took the women.
They never put that in the Ten Commandments. Moses told them to kill the dudes.
Yeah.
Women that that was pretty much that already knew a man.
Yeah.
Young women, keep for yourself.
You got, I mean, you don't just go throwing away some women. That's the spoils of war. That's the point I want to bring out. When King David went into Edom, they killed all the men, and then, I mean, they don't say they took the woman, but come on. What do you think they did with him? That's why I specified that he killed every male. And it's like he killed everyone. He just said every male.
He might have accidentally killed a couple women.
Well, you know, I'm sure some of them died. Because Esau's women are a bunch of whores. Well, all the women are whores. Especially Israel. The Lord said our women would be turned into whores.
Here you go, Malachi 1 and 2.
Oh, that's a good scripture.
I have loved you, said the Lord, yet you say, wherein hast thou loved us? Was not Esau Jacob's brother, said the Lord, yet I loved Jacob. And I hated Esau, and laid his mountains and his heritage waste to the dragons of the ruins. Whereas Edom said, we are impoverished, but we will return and build the desolate places. Thus said the Lord of hosts, they shall build, but I will throw down. And they shall call them the border of wickedness and the people against whom the Lord hath indignation forever.
Forever. Forever. So, but Jesus loves everybody, right?
That's
how stupid as people are, man.
Right.
So forever does mean forever.
Yeah, yeah.
It doesn't mean half of forever. It means forever.
Obadiah 10.
I was just about to get Obadiah.
For thy violence against thy brother Jacob, shame shall cover thee, and thou shalt be cut off forever.
Forever, there's that forever again.
Right. Forever means forever. Shit. In the day that thou stoodest on the other side, in the day that the strangers carried away captive forces, and foreigners entered into the gates, and cast lots upon Jerusalem, even thou wast as one of them. But thou shouldest not have looked on the day of thy brother in the day that he became a stranger. Neither shouldest thou have rejoiced over the children of Judah in the day of their destruction. Neither shouldest thou have spoken proudly in the day of distress. Thou shouldest not have entered into the gate of thy people, entered into the gate of my people in the day of their calamity. Yea, thou shouldest not have looked on their affliction in the day of their calamity.
When the Babylonians came through, bent down, burnt down the temple of the Lord, Esau was laughing at him. And anytime Israel got jacked up and in the history, Esau would make fun of them, laugh at them. They still do it today. When you see the cops would kill somebody, shoot them when they got their hands up, whatever happens. The cops are shooting, everybody making jokes, oh, he got what he deserved. You know, I'd put a couple more bullets in him just to make sure.
Your videos were cracking me up though. And they be shooting motherfuckers running.
Hey, but now they crying about your boy that got shot in Oregon all of a sudden.
Oh, yeah. They mourning like a motherfucker.
They mourning. They are mourning.
They act like that was a lure getting crucified.
Yeah.
For real, that's how they act.
What's his name? Lavoy Finicum or something? Oh, good old Lavoy is out the motherfucking game. He got took the fuck out.
Took him out. When they plowed through that snow and hit, they hit one of the agents.
Oh, did they hit one?
They hit one of them. Where the agent jumped out. It was mainly his fault for jumping out.
Well, you can't blame the guy. He had people with guns on him. He wanted to flee for his freedom. Well, you're supposed to just fucking do what the government says and let them kill you.
That's right. Yeah.
Just, you know, that's what you're supposed to do.
Thou shouldest not have looked on their affliction in the day of their calamity. Nor have laid hands on their substance in the day of their
calamity. Laid hands on their substance in the day of their calamity. Hey, they all fighting over it. Everybody brought that point out over Oregon. They fighting over lands. Who does the land belong to?
Like when the Romans besieged Jerusalem, man. That's pretty much what the Ark of Titus shows. Esau carrying gold. I mean, just all kind of.
Because when they lay siege to a place, too, they camp, the armies will camp around the city and try to starve you out.
Yeah.
They don't just go right in. They camp around you, cut off all the food going in for a while, starve you. You know? Just like you ever hear about all the Israelites that committed suicide on Mount Masada, on the Fort Masada? You heard about that? The big ass, they had a. Is when the Roman, you know, they laid siege to Jerusalem. But you had a bunch of holdouts. They tried to hold out on top of that Mount Masada.
Right, right.
With that little fortress.
Right.
And they all committed suicide instead of, And some people said they even had cannibalism going on up there. I heard that too. Yeah. But you had that too when the Babylonians laid siege to Jerusalem. They cut the food supply off to the city. Everybody started eating each other. That's in the scriptures. It tells you all about it. Oh, they eat the babies first. The wicked-ass woman. Just like in that movie, The Road. The wife went to the husband and said, everyone else is doing it. That's what a woman would say, too. Everyone else is doing it. That's a woman's favorite line. Everyone else is doing it. Why can't I eat pork? Everyone else is doing it. Why can't I be a faggot? Everyone else is doing it. That's what they say. Everyone else is doing it. This is the new times. This ain't the old times. We don't have to stay married no more. Everyone else is getting divorces. That's a bitch's favorite line. That's something a little child would say. Everyone else is doing it.
Amazing. Neither shouldest thou have stood in the crossway to cut off those of his that did escape. Neither shouldest thou have delivered up those of his that did remain in the day of distress. For the day of the Lord is near upon all the heathen. As thou hast done, it shall be done unto thee. Thy reward shall return upon thy own head.
That's what you call karma. You reap what you sow.
I like you reading that.
Yeah.
For the day of the Lord is near upon all the heathen. As thou hast done, it shall be done unto thee. Thy reward shall return upon thy own head. For as ye have drunk upon my holy mountains, so shall all the heathen drink continually. Yea, they shall drink, and they shall swallow down, and they shall be as though they had not been. But upon, what is that? That's Lamentations 4. But upon Mount Zion shall be deliverance, and there shall be holiness, and the house of Jacob shall possess their possessions. And the house of, oh man, it's a bad video with the queen walking through some room, man, and the whole room is just covered with gold, and it's gold stacked up, man. And she's just walking around proud. Ooh, woo.
Nothing lasts forever, bitch.
Right. Like, she's just looking at her like, you know.
And you can, she, anybody gonna deserve to be called a bitch, it's her.
Yeah. That bitch walking around, I know her pussy was getting wet with pus, man.
Probably was.
You know, ain't no pussy juice by air over there. That's pusses or dust. You know?
Creepy ass bitch.
Man, all that gold, man, was good, man. Gold just got a. And we're gonna melt all that shit over again because Esau's hands on it. We're gonna melt all that gold out.
We go no redding.
We're gonna have gold plated walls, man. Right, no redding.
They don't even know who that is.
Esau with a fro.
You know no redding? That is Jimi Hendrix's bass player.
First one?
No, the first one, yeah. Billy Cox was way better. His dude he went in the army with.
He probably like, oh shit. Thank God.
2R East Main to Reynoldsburg.
I ain't gotta hear no more of that.
None of that bullshit.
I ain't gotta hear no more of them Esau scriptures. And the house of Jacob shall be a fire, and the house of Joseph a flame, and the house of Esau for stubble. And they shall kindle in them. And shall devour them, and there shall not be any remaining of the house of Esau, for the Lord has spoken it.
Let me get this.
That was pretty plain and simple.
Lamentations 4 and 17. As for us, our eyes as yet failed for our vain help, and our watching we have watched for a nation that cannot save us. They hunt our steps that we cannot go in our streets. Our end is near. Our days are fulfilled, for our end has come. Our persecutors are swifter than the eagles of the heaven. They pursued us upon the mountains. They laid wait for us in the wilderness. That's what Esau does with the military, the police, and all that.
That's what you just explained a little bit ago when they was up in Whitehall.
Yeah, they just laying wait for your ass. Yeah. They almost got me. I just seen the flashing lights around the corner.
Right.
Because they keep their lights flashing the whole time.
Yeah.
So now, especially you driving on the weekends, man, you better creep around them corners slowly and pay attention to where you going. Yeah, I was creeping slowly.
Hell yeah.
I turned around one corner.
Right.
I was like, shit, I got to turn around. And I went the other way. They was on the other way.
Damn.
I went, they had like three different spots blocked up. I found a secret entrance into Whitehall.
Right.
A turn I never took before. I had to go take the old dipper out.
One of these days, them checkpoints gonna be
everywhere.
Checkpoints to take everybody in.
You ain't gonna be able, all these streets.
I'll beat it up.
And then that day, you ain't gonna wanna walk on no main roads.
You know?
Look, Lamentations 4 and 20. The breath of our nostrils, the anointed of the Lord, was taken in their pits, of whom we said, under his shadow we shall live among the heathen. We living among the heathen right now. Rejoice and be glad, O daughter of Edom, that dwelleth in the land of Uz. The cup also shall pass through unto thee.
That cup again.
That shall be drunken and shall make thyself naked. The punishment of thine iniquity is accomplished, O daughter of Zion. He will no more carry thee away into captivity. He will visit thine iniquity, O daughter of Edom. He will discover thy sins. So when we get up, when this shit goes down, we ain't going back into captivity, man.
Never gonna happen.
It ain't never gonna happen again. You got some people, we're going to rule the earth with the Lord for 1,000 years, and the Satan's going to come back out.
They teaching that shit, too.
How crazy shit is that, man? Big non-scripture knowing heathens.
They think that 1,000 years of shit is coming.
That's already happened.
Yeah.
That 1,000 years what was pretty much the Byzantine Empire that lasted 1,000 years. When Constantine came in, before Constantine became emperor, all the Christians were all getting put to death, getting crucified, fed to lions, all the way up to the emperor right before Constantine.
Hey, they wouldn't know that anyway because they don't know history.
They don't know history. Constantine stopped all that persecution. And then, even, you know, when he became emperor, if any Christians had their land stolen from them or money taken from them, he reimbursed them. He gave them all their money back, their land back. So people say, well, Constantine was a pagan. It may have been, but he stopped the persecutions. And he made it so that we took shit over. You know what I'm saying? And guess what? There wasn't no Jews allowed. No, Jews were considered a second-class citizen. Well, not Jews. I don't like that word, Jew. The so-called Jews, they was considered to be second-class citizens. You know, during the so-called Dark Ages, you know, usury was illegal, right? You wasn't allowed to charge nobody usury. That was against the law.